I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, principle of superposition problem. Determine the stresses in various segments of a circular bar as shown in the figure. This is the circular bars, step bar it is, circular section as shown in the figure. Compute the total elongation taking the Young's modulus to be 195 GPa. Now here, this P4 is unknown. Everything is known. First, we have to find out this P4. How? We are going to find out with the help of summation of f of x is equal to 0. We are treating f of x is equal to 0. Now, I will assume a concept. This side I will treat as a positive. This side I will consider as a negative, and this one a negative. Now, 100 is a negative. I will write here. Minus 100, and this becomes positive, this arrow is here, plus 300, again 250, negative direction, minus 250, and this one plus P4 is equal to 0. If you calculate the value, the P4 is nothing but 50 kilonewton. 50 kilonewton. You have to bring entire this value, this side, it becomes 50 kilonewton. Now the P4 value is 50 kilonewton. 50 kilonewton. Now, we have to find out the stresses in each segment. Now I will consider this as a one section, this one as a one section, this second section, and this will be third section. First, I will consider the section 1. Section 1. This is the diagram for section 1. First, I will draw this arrow. It is 100 kilonewton. Now, this part reaches here. 300 kilonewton. 250 kilonewton. Next is P, that is P4 is nothing but 50 kilonewton. Now, calculate this part. How to calculate? The arrow this side indicate it is a positive, right? 300. The arrow this side indicate negative, minus 250. And the arrow this side indicate plus 50. If you calculate this part, it will be 100, positive 100, plus 100. That means this one return in this way. This is 100 kilonewton, and this part positive indicate the arrow is here. 100 kilonewton. That means it is tension plus. Next, I will go for segment 2 or section 2. Section 2, I will consider the same box, this box, here in this part. Now, this will comes here, 100 kilonewton, this one comes here, 300 kilonewton, and these two will be on this surface. This will be 250 kilonewton and 50 kilonewton. Now, arrow. This arrow indicate what? Minus 100 plus 300. This arrow indicate positive sign, positive, negative. The value will be for this one is 200. Value will be 200. That to positive. Positive. That means first arrow we have obtained. Positive means the arrow should be this direction. Positive 200 kilonewton. What about this one? Calculate, the arrow will be this direction. 250. One more is plus This will be minus 250 because arrow indicates here minus, and this will be positive plus 50. The answer for this one is minus 200. Minus indicate arrow will be this direction. Now arrow will be this direction. 200 kilonewton. That means this is compressive force. Compressive force. Similarly, I will go for section 3. Section 3. I will consider this part again. Now, here it is already 50 kilonewton. We are going to check whether it is a 50 kilonewton or not. Now, first part is 100. Right here 100 in this direction. Kilonewton. Next is 300 in this direction. Next is 250 in this direction. Now calculate this part. This arrow indicate minus 100. This arrow positive plus 300, and this arrow negative minus 250. This becomes 50. Now this is nothing but, this is 100, this becomes minus 50. That means if it is minus indicate the arrow should be this direction. 50 kilonewton. Don't write minus here. Minus only indicate the directions. Minus 50. And already it is 50 in this direction. Kilonewton. Now these are in the equilibrium condition. That is tension, compression, compression. Sorry, tension. Tension, compression, tension. Now here, now we are going to find out the stresses in each portion or each segment. Section 1, sigma 1 is equal to P1 by A1. What is P here? 100. It is positive 100. 100 into 10 raised to 3. What is area? Pi by 4 into D square. Area should be pi by 4 into d square, because it is a circular section. D square is nothing but they are given at 20 square. The answer for this one is 318.309 newton per mm square. Sigma 2, section 2. This is section 1, section 2. P2 divided by A2, you can write P1 here. P2 is nothing but 200 into 10 raised to 3 pi by 4 into 25 square. They are given 25 area. The answer for this one is 407.436 newton per mm square. Similarly, section, this is 2, 1, 3. Sigma 3 is equal to P3 by A3. 50 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi by 4. Area will be 24, sorry, diameter will be 15 into 15 square. The answer will be 2.942 newton per mm square. This indicate, as per the diagram, it will in tension, right, tension here, and this will be the compression. Compressions, these two are compressions. These are two are compression. Now we have to find out the individual elongations. Now we are going to find out the elongations. Elongation of the section 1, elongation of section 1. How to find out the elongation? Formula will be delta L1 is equal to P1 L1 divided by A E1. E is given as, here E is 195 GPa. We have to convert into 195 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. We have to convert into Newton per mm square. Multiply with 10 raised to 3. What is P value? 100. 100 into 10 raised to 3. What is length L1? This is the L1. This act as the L1, L2 and L3. N1 is 100 divided by area pi by 4 into d square is nothing but 20 square. Young's modulus 195 into 10 raised to 3. The answer will be 0.163 mm. Now elongation for elongation of section 2, formula delta L2 is equal to P2 L2 divided by A2 E. What is P2 here? Now P2 is 200, write it 200 into 10 raised to 3. What is L? 200, this is the 200, 200 divided by pi by 4, d square is 25 square. 25 square into 195 into 10 raised to 3. The answer for this one is 0.417 mm. Similarly, elongation of section 3. Delta L3 is equal to P3 L3 divided by A2 E. Now, what is P3 here? P3 is 50. Write it 50 here. 50 into 10 raised to 3. L is nothing but how much? 150. 150 divided by pi by 4 into d square 15. Diameter is d square 15 here. 15 square is equal to 195 into 10 raised to 3. The answer for this one is 0.2176 mm. Now we are going to find out the net elongation. We are going to find out the net elongation. Net elongation we have to find out. How to find out? Net elongation. Delta L is equal to, now first one. As per the diagram, this is tension, this is compression and this is tension. You have to write in this. Delta L1 is tension. Delta L2 is compression. Plus delta L3 is tension. Tension, compression, again this one is tension based on the diagram. These are the diagrams. Tension, compression and tension. Now substitute the value. First value is 0.163 minus 0.417 plus 0.2176. The answer will be minus 0.0364 mm. Here minus indicate contraction. Minus indicate contraction. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.